Right, well, good morning, everybody. I actually started in the Domino's business 22 years ago now as a 14-year-old team member in my hometown of Tamworth. So I've been around in the business for a long time and worked in a lot of positions. And the one I'm most proud of is that I was a franchisee for 9 years at that time. I built a network of 18 stores. And so I've seen a lot of things in this business. You might not know Domino's Pizza Enterprises' history very much either. And our history is actually, we started as a Brisbane-based pizza company called Silvio's Dialer Pizza. And we're still a Brisbane-based, albeit global company today. And back in 1996, Silvio's bought the rights to Domino's Pizza. And Domino's Pizza had been broke three times in Sydney, actually, before that time. And like many businesses who try to get into a new market and get scale, they had got to about 20 or 30 stores, and they'd blinked because the losses were eye-watering, and they'd lost their nerve to grow the market. And our chairman back in that time, who's still our chairman today, was very resolute in his view, and the view that Jack had was that you got to think about this as like building a 100-story building. The first 50 or 60 gets you, pays your way, and you have to get to the 100 floors to finish it. And our business is very much like that. It's a business of scale and leverage. And if I use that analogy and look at what happens in the franchising business or a retail business like ours, you have to get to a point where you can build up that scale and leverage. And for us, it's things like purchasing power, it's being able to build technology, it's about being able to buy a television signal and build a brand. And you don't get to that point unless you can get those stores on the ground. And we're very proud that we've been able to do that and have those foundations in place, not only here in Australia and New Zealand, but we now operate over 2,500 stores across 8 different countries around the world. And that business is leveraging that size and scale to deliver returns for our shareholders, our franchisees, and our customers. So I'm going to zoom in and talk about Australia and New Zealand a little bit because that's my area of the business, and I think we get a lot of questions on Australia and New Zealand. Although if you are investing in Domino's Pizza Enterprise today, the largest part of that growth is coming from our other markets. So we have a target of 1,200 stores to achieve here in Australia and New Zealand by 2028. And we're currently at 825, and I want to share with you quickly how we think about getting there. So if you look at the QSR market today in Australia and New Zealand, it's nearly $30 billion. And of that, pizza represents about 7%. So in the context of the rest of the world, the US, for example, pizza is 18% of the total QSR, which is our industry. So, Australians could eat a lot more pizza. And one of our reasons why they don't is there's been some really sophisticated players in burgers and chicken and sandwiches who have done a really great job, and they've almost over-earned inside the category. So today, whilst we're really big in pizza, we make up 43% of all pizza consumed here, we're really, really small in total QSR. And that, for us, is where that growth is. And that is how we have been growing. So you can see, whilst that number 3.6 is small, it was even smaller 4 or 5 years ago when it was about 2.8. So we have been growing the category through taking share from other occasions. So a question I get asked a lot is, Domino's in Australia and New Zealand is the most penetrated Domino's market in the world. And that is true bar Iceland, but I wouldn't consider that to be a major market. And we have an average of 35,000 head of population per Domino's store, and we have a target to get to 28,000, which is when we hit that 1,200 store target. So how does that look, and why do we think we can get there? Well, like I said, Australians can eat a lot more pizza, and I think this shows gives some context as to why that's the case. So if we look at the top four players inside the category in Australia and the US, you can see here that Americans have a chain pizza store for every 15,000 head of population, whereas Australians, it's over 20,000. So, whilst we're a really strong player, it's inside a category that could be a lot bigger and grow a lot more. We're already doing it. So if I look at a market like Queensland for us, which is one of our strong home market, we have an average population per store of 25,000 there today. So we're well ahead of the target that we've set for ourselves. And we have a lot of stores we can open in Queensland. But that just goes to show that we can well and truly achieve that, and we don't need to achieve the levels of penetration in, say, Victoria, as we do have in Queensland. I'm going to switch gears now and talk a little bit about innovation, and one of the things I'm really proud of is our pizza checker project. The number one complaint from our customers is that our pizza, or my pizza, doesn't look like it should. And you know, we've been really trying to invest in tools that give our franchisees, our store managers, and our team members the tools to be able to improve how they execute. And Pizza Checker is that. So what does Pizza Checker do? Well, essentially it's a video camera above the cut table in each of our stores. And what it does in that capacity is it checks to make sure that the pizza is the right pizza. Would you believe it or not, we actually have millions of combinations that can be achieved making a pizza inside a Domino's store today because of the number of ingredients, crusts. People add toppings, take them away, so quite a complicated thing to do. It grades that pizza, gives it a score, a pass or a fail based on whether it's made correctly, and then it identifies whether, if it hasn't been made correctly, if it needs to be remade again. So how that then translates into the real experience is there's a screen in the store that the people cutting, the team members cutting pizzas can see, and they're able to get that live feedback. And then we pass that feedback onto our teams who are making pizzas so that they can adjust where necessary or remake a pizza where it needs to be done. What you're seeing is the technology identifying what it knows to be a pizza. So that shading area, that little blue dot there that's identifying pizza 2 or pizza 3, what it's doing is constantly recording a video because the pizza's always moving. There's hands over the top, people are cutting it, they're adding things on as they go. And it is trying to look for what it believes to be a clean shot. And then from there, in just over a second, it makes an assessment based on all of the machine learning that it has as to whether that's the right amount of toppings, whether it's got the right amount of cheese, is it cooked properly, are they spread correctly, and then it's grading all that up just inside a second and then displaying an answer. And then in real time, if you've ordered on one of our digital platforms, you actually get a picture of your pizza inside the app and you can meet it before you eat it, right? You can see, has it been approved? And if it has been approved, it'll get the quality tick. And if it hasn't, we'll send you a message to let you know that we're remaking your pizza and there'll be a small delay. So that's how it's working today, but we have a lot more to do in this area and a lot more investment to make, and we're going to continue to improve that part of our platform. It's going to be able to get smarter. We're going to be able to share this data in different places to really help our team members execute and help them see what needs to be improved and really get the recognition for doing a great job, because sometimes people think these things are really negative, but actually in the real world, our teams are competitive. They like to do a good job. Most people get up in the morning wanting to do well, and this is one way of giving them a yardstick to say what they're doing really well at and where they can improve. And people love that. They have great fun, they compete, and it helps us get better and execute for the customer.